for a year and a half. And then afterwards, too.
Maybe.
You talk, you smell it, taste it. Just all paramedic.
Do not taste caramel.
You poop it?
I'm just going all senses of that.
That's a great way to get, like,
head C. I have to eat my head C back.
You can't get head C through the mouth, so it's
okay. Yikes. I'm really glad I shared that out. No regrets, I took a risk.
Others? Have you figured out a theme that I have tried to give you? Because I'm going to demonstrate that today also.
Don't suck.
Strive for excellence in everything. Okay?
I think it's good.
Very much.
Don't try to be, do.
Can you expand on that, or can you put that into different words? I'm just curious on how you interpret what you just said.
Just because you don't know a skill, don't try to do that skill, perform a skill in the way that you know how to do it, and then be willing to correct it before you find the incorrect. So don't try. Do your stuff.
Okay.
And then alter as needed. Once you learn more material, you learn more techniques, and you continue on doing as opposed to just trying.
Okay. Yeah.
Know why you're doing what you're doing.
Okay.
Don't be afraid to make mistakes here.
Sure. Yeah. You guys are all getting different components of what I think my ultimate mission is. Anything else? I'm gonna show you a clip of a video of a movie. Some of you may have seen the movie. If you did, just enjoy the clip. It's my favorite part of this particular movie. It's my favorite clip of this particular movie. And I'll try to explain it at the end briefly in terms of what I'm trying to get across. Coming into 1980, and I'm sorry if you don't like sports, it's a sports movie.
I love sports.
I'm a sports guy, so if you don't like sports, well, deal with it. Coming into 1980, there was absolutely nobody in the world better than the Russians.
Yes, miracle.
Sorry.
Oh, is this the coach speech?
It's such a good movie.
Oh, we're going to watch the coach speech?
I'm going to watch a coach speech.
Oh, damn it.
You need to understand, though, coming into 1980 and talking about the Russians and their hockey, for 15 years prior to that, for the 15 years prior to the 1980s, the Russians weren't just the best hockey team in the world. The second best team, which was Czechoslovakia, were like infantile baby whiners compared to the Russians. And Czechoslovakia was so far above everyone else that it was ridiculous. There wasn't anyone that could touch the Russians. There was nobody that could skate with the Russians. You couldn't even be on the ice with them. They were that much better than everybody. Absolutely better than everybody. They'd won the gold at the previous three Olympics by such a high margin that it was laughable. And anybody even thinking about beating the Russians was laughable. Nobody could beat them. And there's a coach by the name of Herb Brooks, who was the coach for University of Michigan. And he went to Colorado to interview to be the Olympic coach for the Americans. And this is after other coaches had already said no way. There weren't any coaches that wanted to be the Olympic coach because first of all, the Americans were so terrible, it wasn't even funny. They weren't even on the ice with the Canadians, let alone the Czechoslovakians, let alone the Russians. It was just silly. It was terrible. And he walked in and basically said, I want to be the coach, and I'm going to do everything different. And the Olympic Committee looked at him like he was nuts for wanting to do anything different. And his basic argument was, their argument was they didn't want to be embarrassed by his new style, and his argument was, you know, in all the previous years, we've been so embarrassed, it's not even any funny, how am I going to embarrass us anymore? you might as well give me a chance to do what I want to do. And they did. And then this is just a clip of their first match. So it's going to take a few minutes, but it encompasses what I'm trying to get across. Some of you will understand it very quickly. Some of you will struggle with that. But so bear with me and enjoy Annalise's favorite movie of the day.
Wait, was this
one?
It's a great one.
Just say it.
It's a short clip, so you don't have to scale. They're in Norway right now. Enjoy.
Don't hurt yourselves.
Did the projector turn off?
No.
Oh, that's weird. I'll switch it too. I haven't tried the locker. I got them in my locker.
I got a couple more in the office.
I haven't tried those ones. The cherry is really good. It's like that really, at least the smell is like that really smelly.
There you go. You might have to deal with the volume this way.
The hair you're
Thank you, that's...
You guys don't want to work during the game? No problem, we'll work now. Go on. That one. Thank you. Gentlemen, you don't have enough talent to win on talent alone. Again. 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 Come on, Craig, blow the whistle. Again. Michael Ruzioni! Winthrop, Massachusetts!
Single time, they said who they were, they said where they came from, and they said what college they played for. It's the first time that someone said they played for the U.S. What was he looking for? Every single one of those players were outstanding hockey players. They were phenomenal hockey players. Every single one of them made the Olympic team. They're fantastic. What was he looking for?
For them to be part of the team, not part of the individual.
Complete,
it's more.
Complete commitment.
What else? What was that? What else? There's something else here.
The understanding of who they were representing wasn't their school. They're representing America.
More.
On the ice.
Which meant what? What was that for them?
Something.
Did it change them
as
a player?
No.
Were they all of a sudden a different player?
No. It's not going to make them a different player. It's an understanding of the level of commitment and excellence they need to show on the ice.
Did they not think they had a level of commitment coming in? Did they not know that it was going to be a serious commitment for them?
Oh, they did. But it's conceptual. It's not until you actually do that you
say that again.
It's conceptual.
Say it again. Say it again.
Conceptual.
The mindset. What have I been talking to you guys about?
Mindset.
When you're practicing skills. Remember that day? Yeah. What was it? What was it about?
Stop.
Stop. Until what?
Until I treated the patient and not the proctor.
Did you all of a sudden do your skills differently?
No.
Did you all of a sudden have I can do this skill now and I couldn't before?
No.
What was it?
I saw the person in front of me as a patient and not a mannequin.
It's a mindset. Everything about this stuff is about a mindset. We had, in last year's class, we had two individuals. We had a lot of individuals in the class. We had two individuals that were almost identical in terms of their life logistics. They were the same in terms of what they had to deal with family. They were the same with what they had to deal with work. They were the same in terms of what they were having to deal with. They both worked for the same organization. One of those individuals talked to us early on and continued to talk to us and had nothing but problems. Couldn't get his ER time done. Couldn't get his OR time done. He missed some classes here and there. He had struggles constantly that he was trying to deal with, and he was getting behind in class. He was having a hard time getting through class. The other individual The other individual, we never heard from. We never heard from. We never had a single complication. They got everything done. They were where they were supposed to be every single time. They never missed a single shift. We didn't even know this, but they were partners on the same shift. Not only did they have the same life circumstances, they actually had the exact same schedule. We would not have guessed that. She demonstrated absolutely no challenges whatsoever to schedule and no challenges whatsoever to making everything that had to be made. It's a mindset. Everything is about a mindset. Everything that you do, everything that you approach is about a mindset. I don't know who said it. It's not about paramedic. I love paramedic, don't get me wrong. But I could care less about paramedic. It's the same thing for a musician when they walk up on stage for rehearsal. It's the same thing for an athlete that's going into practice. It's the same thing for a teacher who's stepping in front of a high school group and they're ready to do whatever they have to do. It's the same thing for somebody who's a chef that's going in to cook food. It's a mindset, and it's how you view yourself. And it's how you view yourself in relation to what you're about to do. Some of you, I need to see that click, right? When you're approaching something, how are you approaching it? What's your mindset for how you're approaching it? I know I gave you that speech a while back about how you're already a paramedic, right? I don't actually mean you're a paramedic yet. You're still learning, right? But it's a mindset for how you approach it, right? That was one of the biggest things that we saw in that lab that we did that was kind of a competition lab. We weren't doing it because we wanted to see you compete just for the fun of competing. Some of you do well with competition and some of you don't do well with competition. The competition was irrelevant. It was some of you approached it as I'm taking this seriously and I'm going to do this. I'm just gonna do it. I'm gonna do it. I'm not gonna try, I'm gonna go in and do it. And others didn't approach it that way. It was a very telling moment because of that, right? It's a mindset. What's your mindset going to be? That makes sense? I'm sorry that I wasted your time for a little bit here for some of you, but some of you will get that, right? I hope all of you get that. It's a mindset. What is your mindset going to be? What would you say? Conceptual. It's how you conceptualize what it is that you're about to do. Right? He didn't have to work them out like that. It's not like they needed that workout. Well, they did, actually, but that's beside the point. It's not like they needed the workout. They needed to get to the point where their mindset was in the right place. And in this particular case, for 7 months, all he wanted them to realize is who they played for. That when they stepped out there, they weren't, there was a conflict between a couple of the individuals on that team because in the previous national championship, there was pushing and shoving that caused some issues. And so they had strife because they weren't playing together as a team, as their own team. They were still thinking about what team they used to be on. All he wanted them was to recognize that they're playing on this team, right? It's all about a mindset. Everything in your life is about a mindset, okay? What's your mindset gonna be?
Okay. I don't know what to watch tonight.